I want to bring in Representative Doug Collins. He's running for the Senate in Georgia. Are you ready? And you are ready to hold China accountable. You've got some interesting legislation that will hold them firmly accountable for at least their negligence in the coronavirus crisis. But a lot of folks in the media and a lot of your colleagues on Capitol Hill don't want to hold them accountable. We'll talk about what you have planned, but why is there this reluctance to hold them responsible for their mistakes?
It goes back to an old, I think, adage that we have to be, you know, we have to be weak many times to make sure that if we just be nice to people, they'll get better. You can't get nice to a dictatorship. You can't get nice to a communist party that represses its own people. And President Trump has led the way in holding China accountable. And in the mainstream media, and some of my colleagues don't like that. They would rather try a different approach. But the approach with a totalitarian regime is that you address them head on. President Trump's done that through the trade deals. He's done it through his discussions. And we have legislation that will hold the members of the Communist Party and their leadership, freeze their assets. It will restrict their travel, restricts travel for others coming from China. It also says that if you don't participate in the investigation of international proportions that understands why this happened and where it came from, if you don't let go of the protesters in Hong Kong who are peacefully protesting against your regime and when you're not following up what you're supposed to be doing, if you're not doing these things, then these things are, are issues that the president can use to fight back. That's the only thing they understand is when their money supply and their influence is cut off, then they're actually responsive.
All right. Wouldn't you upgrade those sanctions if, I know everybody seems to accept that they made some very crucial mistakes at the Wuhan lab. There are some who believe, and they're not totally convinced that they're wrong, that this might have been deliberate. This might have been a risky experiment. They wanted to release it, maybe not this much. Maybe they only had the antidote for it. As you know, they've killed their own people before, China has, especially during the Cultural Revolution. Some would not put this past them. If, first of all, do you think that's possible?
If that's found out to be true, I mean, look, the Communist Party has done, as you just said, many things to their own people. They do it continually, even without a virus. But, and if that is found out to be true, then that raises the stakes to a whole different level.
All right. Well, we will see. By the way, you're in Georgia right now, correct? Forgive me. You're yes.
Oh, I'm in Georgia.
All right. Not in Capitol Hill. Yeah, right. They're not doing much on Capitol Hill.
Yeah, be there tomorrow.
Be there tomorrow. Reopening. Georgia took some heat initially, even from the president, for possibly moving too fast. We saw a spike in cases. Are you comfortable with where Georgia is right now?
Georgia's responded well. After the initial understanding of what we could do and how we could do it and make sure that communication is clear, Georgia's have responded well, and I think Georgia's is leading the way in seeing this comeback happen, and that's a good thing. We, you know, it's always tough to begin starting when you had to make sure everybody was on the same page. Some got on the same page, and when they did, Georgia's responded, and we're seeing it so far, seeing it respond very well.
Are you seeing a difference in red state counties versus blue state counties? Blue counties versus red counties and how they respond and how quickly they want to or actually do open up?
It's a little bit of both. I think you're definitely seeing our rural, our red counties are responding. I mean, up in my part of the world, you're seeing people want to go to the stores. They're going to the restaurants. They're starting to get back out. The ones who don't need to be out are not getting back out. Again, common sense is being practiced. But in other areas, there has been such a media onslaught of fear that you can't do anything, that some are still, you know, not wanting to get out. And we've got to get up to a situation where people feel comfortable about getting back out of our economy, getting started, and people being safe.
Nobody knows more about Obamagate potentially than you and a handful of your colleagues and the travesty that's happened to General Flynn. What do you think of this judge who now has actually lawyered up himself, which is very unusual? It seems like he has a personal vendetta against, this is Judge Sullivan, against Flynn. Again, the government wants to drop the case. The defense obviously wants the case dropped, but the judge is sticking to it.
This judge is went way outside the bounds. He wants to be prosecutor. He wants to be a defense attorney, I guess, for himself. He wants to do his own inquiry and his own investigation. A judge is there to make sure that the trial and the procedures go as according to law. They're not there to insert themselves into an ex parte, let me investigate on my own kind of thing, or accept what has actually been worked on with the parties. Now, there's a part that can happen here, but when you have the prosecution saying, we no longer want to be a part of this, it is a part where he should let it go. And the appeals court is saying, you now have to answer to that. But again, Greg, for the most part, let's go back and remember this. This is simply what a confirmation of what many of us have been saying from the start. This was nothing but a corrupt cabal with Comey and struck and McCabe and Page, and it goes all the way to the Oval Office now, as we found out, to Obama, Biden, Rice, and others.
Yep. I'm waiting for that Durham report, that U.S. attorney who's investigating. I think there are some guys over there that are pretty nervous from the old administration. Congressman Collins, good luck. Thanks so much for joining us, all right?
Greg, it's great to be with you. Take care.
All right.